Halo, itu suaranya Sandy. Hari ini aku jemput dia lagi. Bener-bener deh itu suaranya. Halo Sandy. Waduh, kayak anjing dicekek. Iya. Ih. Halo, iya Sandy. Halo Horsi, ih sombong. Kemarin mau. Halo, good horse. Iya Sandy, ya ampun. Sini turun, come here. Sini. Halo Horsi. Ih, ya ampun. Hey, come here. Gak usah teriak, kenapa? Ih, teriak-teriak kayak diapain? Anjing bener-bener deh. Ya, tunggu, bentar. Iya, Sandy, tutup pintu dulu. Iya Sandy, aduh suaranya. Jadi ini nyambung sama sungai pantai yang kemarin itu, kalau jalan terus nyambung ke sini, terus ada jalan di bawah jembatan. Bentar. Jadi ini tuh nantinya bakal nyambung sama taman yang di seberang sana, itu taman untuk anjing. Jadi anjing bebas lari-lari ke sana. Enak ya? Di Indonesia mana ada ya? Si Sandy seneng banget kalau disuruh lari-lari. Oh ya, aku mau ceritain mumpung lagi di sini. Ini tempatnya. Nah, di sebelah sana itu tempat dulu aku nikah. Nikahnya di pinggir sungai. Pakai sendal jepit.
Apa? Sendal jepit?
Iya beneran. Aku nikah sama Mots. Santai aja pakai sendal jepit. Yang datang waktu itu banyak banget. Ya lari-lari. Happy Sandy? Nanti aku kasih videonya ya, aku waktu nikah.
Everybody got their phones turned on. gentlemen and children. We are gathered here today to share in a wedding between Matthew Potts and Esti Hardy-Petrie. The participation of each of you in this ceremony is important to them, and they hope that they can together draw strength from your company at this time, just as they have in the past drawn happiness from your friendship. My name is Karen Nerthen, and I'm a civil marriage celebrant, authorised to solemnise marriages according to the Marriage Act. Before you are joined together in marriage, in my presence and in the presence of these, your family and friends, I'm to remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship you are now about to enter. Marriage, according to the law in Australia, is the union of two people, to the exclusion of all others, voluntarily entered into for life. Matthew and Esti believe that this wedding is an expression of their love, a love which has grown from the comfort of closeness and which has led to the deep understanding and respect that each has for the other. A love which involves the acceptance of each other's weaknesses and faults and the consideration of each other's individuality. They believe that those qualities that attract each to the other will be best developed during a life spent together. A happy marriage will enable them to establish a home where their children can be raised in love and stability, a home where their family and friends will always be welcome. But what is marriage? Matthew and Esti believe their marriage is based upon the need for being and living together and the emotional security that that provides. True friendship and companionship can only be present when there is compatibility of intellect, of temperament, of interests and tastes, but above all, a mutual affection and attraction. Your marriage today makes firm your commitment, and we, your family and friends, wish you both every possible happiness, contentment and joy for your future together. Today, you come together from your own separate backgrounds, different in memory and experiences that will not change, but will add to your future so that as you become one, you will always remain two. Once in a lifetime, you find someone who touches not only your heart, but also your soul. You discover someone who stands beside you and respects you. You find someone who loves you for what you are, not what you could be. Once in a lifetime, if you are fortunate, you will find someone as you two here today have found each other. Today, there is a vast and unknown future stretching out before you. The possibilities and potentials of your married life are great, and now falls upon your shoulders the task of choosing values and making a reality of your dreams. In this way, you will create the meaning of your life. On this day of your marriage, you stand somewhat apart from other human beings. You stand within the charmed circle of your love, and this is as it should be. But love is not meant to be the possession of two people alone. Rather, it should serve as a source of common energy, as a form in which you find the strength to live your lives together with courage. From this day onward, you will come closer together than ever before. You will love one another in sickness and in health, and for better and for worse. But at the same time, your love should give you the strength to stand apart, to seek out your unique destinies, and to make your special contribution to the world. You stand before me today as two mature and thoughtful people who wish to express your emotions within the framework of a meaningful life. For your self-reliance and for your courage and for your love, you deserve respect. I should like at this time to speak of the thing which all of us here wish for you. We wish for you a love that makes both of you better people, that continues to give you the joy and zest for living, and that provides you with the energy to face the challenges of your new life together. Real love is something beyond the warmth and glow, the excitement and romance of being deeply in love. It is caring about as much about the welfare and happiness of your marriage partner as about your own. But real love is not total absorption in each other. It is looking out within the same direction together. Love makes your burdens lighter because you divide them. It makes your joys more intense because you share them. And it makes you both stronger so that you can reach out and become involved with life in ways you would dare not risk alone. The beautiful thing about love is that it's an experience we share with the whole of mankind throughout the world. And yet to everyone who falls in love, it is is the most unique, precious thing in the world. A really happy marriage is founded on love, loyalty, and honesty. Love works in ways that are wondrous and strange, and there is nothing in life that love cannot change. Love is unselfish, understanding, and kind, and sees with the heart and not with the mind. There is no stronger bond between husband and wife to ensure and secure a happy married life. So Matthew, will you take Esty to be your lawful wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Esty, will you take Matthew to be your lawful husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only unto him as long as you both shall live? Matthew and Esty, the promise that you make together today is significant because it will bind you together for life in a relationship so close and so intimate that it will profoundly influence your whole future. That future, with its hopes and its disappointments, its successes and failures, its pleasures and pains, and its joys and its sorrows. You know that these elements are mingled in every life and are to be expected in your own. So not knowing what is before you, you take each other through the best and the worst that life lies ahead until death. So will you join your hands now and commit yourselves to each other? Repeat after me, Matthew. I call upon the persons here present.
I call upon the persons here present.
To witness that I, Matthew.
Witness that I, Matthew.
Take you, Esty.
Take you, Esty.
To be my lawful wedded wife. I intend to be faithful to you in thought, word, and deed. I promise to respect you as an individual in your own right.
Respect you
as an individual in your own right. I intend to grow and develop in partnership with you. To love you and live with you, through good fortune and adversity. Adversity. I pledge these things to you while we both live. Good. Okay, Steve. I call upon the persons here present. To witness that I, Esty.
To witness that I, Esty.
Take you, Matthew.
Take you, Matthew.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
I intend to be faithful to you.
I intend to be faithful to you.
In thought, word, and deed.
In thought, word, and deed.
I promise to respect you.
I promise to respect you.
As an individual.
As an individual.
In your own right.
In your own right.
I intend to grow and develop.
I intend to grow and develop.
In partnership with you.
In partnership with you.
To love you and live with you.
To
love you,
and live with you.
Through good fortune and adversity.
Through good fortune and adversity.
I pledge these things to you.
I pledge these things to you.
While we both live.
While we both live.
The giving of a wedding ring is a symbol of true faith in each other and serves as a reminder of your faith, love, and commitment. It is also a symbol of unity, truth, love, and life, that which has no beginning or end. So, could we please have the rings? give this ring to you. As a symbol of our love. I marry you, you marry me.
I give this ring to you as a symbol of love. I marry you, you marry me.
Yeah. Rikoji promised to share your lives together in marriage. We recognize and respect the covenant that you have made here before us. May you have a long and happy life together. You have this day declared your consent before me and your family and friends, and so by virtue of the authority vested in me, I pronounce you to be husband and wife.
What happened to the breeze? There was one 20 minutes ago.
She's not jumping in the river. It's all right, it's all right.
You're filming the whole thing.
Of course I'm filming the whole
big smile, Matt.
Beautiful smile.
Nanti aku kasih videonya ya, aku waktu nikah. Yang datang tuh waktu itu kita baru pindah, terus kenalnya hanya tetangga kiri kanan dan sekitar gitu deh. Terus juga kenal beberapa. Akhirnya kita nikah di situ, terus ngundang tetangga. Karena waktu itu mama papaku nggak bisa datang, keluarga di Indonesia juga nggak bisa, karena mahal tiketnya. Jadi yang datang keluarganya Matt. Terus yang jadi wali, bukan wali sih, yang mengantar aku ke pelaminan, cailah tempat pelaminan, itu omnya Matt. Karena papahnya Matt kan udah gak ada, itu omnya. Terus yang jadi saksi nikah itu temen deketnya Matt. Nah, pas di sini nih kita nikahnya. Waktu itu izin numpang nikahnya sih gak bayar, tapi kita cuman bayar apa itu namanya yang nikahin penghulu. Bayar penghulu $550. Udah sampai rumah lagi. Jadi gitu deh, begitulah video kali ini aku ceritain soal nikahanku. Soalnya waktu itu kan banyak yang nanya, kapan nikah, di mana, aku nggak ngundang-ngundang sih. Jadi ya gitu. Ini aku lagi duduk di depan perapian. Perapiannya nggak nyala sih, tapi di sini lagi ada matahari, jadi aku duduk di sini. Oke, sekian video kali ini. Jadi tolong ya di-share, di-komen, di-like, subscribe, jangan lupa. Ya. Aku nanti bikin video lagi pesta habis nikah ya. Ditunggu.